from Pakistan, that this is the most beautiful church in the whole world, because I have never experienced this.
Mm-hmm.
It does not happen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You will not tell me that is what you do in your denomination, but we have been in the same denomination elsewhere, but it has never happened. So you are special. Praise the Lord. Tell the person next to you, you are special. Because how would the servant of God just come and receive? Praise the Lord. Can you imagine if the rapture takes place right now? You people, glory be to Jesus. Hallelujah. If the rapture takes place right now, you've already blessed the Lord. You are reminding me of that woman with the alabaster bottle. Glory to God. The Lord wants to change the message. It's not what I prepared. Then it's like that woman with the alabaster bottle. She came to Jesus. And you know what she did? She passed through names that were in the house. And it, to make the matters worse, it was a leper's house. Simon the leper. Can you imagine? Somebody, imagine with his name, and then what concludes that name? Hallelujah. But she breaks the protocol, because women are not supposed to go where men were. And during that time, women were not supposed to go where men were. But this woman, she decides, I am breaking the protocol because I know what God has done for me. When you know what God has done for you, when you experience the love of God, you can do anything. And that's what you have done. Praise to Jesus. This is the church where you come to preach, and I want to tell every preacher that comes here, if you're coming here to preach in El Shaddai Grace Center, that is that this is Nigadini. You have to make sure you prepare well, because this is a loving church. Glory to Jesus. You are a loving church. You're a church that knows how to give back to the Lord. Not just how to receive from the Lord, but how to give to the Lord. You are blessed. You are a rich church. I want to declare in your life that it is going to be the wealthiest church in Kenya. When you're talking about wealth, at least it's going to be the wealthiest church, because you have not been guided to keep your treasures, but you have treasured the Lord more than what you have, and treasure the Lord more than yourself. That is why God is going to do great things in your life. Whoever that I came here with a need, let me tell you, you're not living this place with a need, because you have touched the hem of the Lord's garments. Praise to Jesus. You have touched the Lord's garments in everything you have with your heart. Because when you purpose to give to the Lord, even before he does anything to you, just thanking him for the great things he has done, the Lord is surely going to do something great. Hallelujah. I want to remind you of this man of God. His name, he was a king, Solomon. Solomon, when he was asked by the Lord, now what do I do for you, because your worship is great. Then you people, you are great worshippers. Praise the Lord. You are great worshippers. I'm grateful that I came to you, a church that knows how to worship the Lord. Because when Solomon was asked by the Lord after worshiping God, because you know what, he worshiped God and gave God everything. And we are told that what Solomon gave, it is almost equivalent to almost all the wealth of Africa. That's what he gave to the Lord. And you have given all. Praise you to Jesus. Amen. You decide to give the servant of God before giving your church offering. You are special, you people. You are special. Praise the Lord. You are special. I am telling you, I am amazed. So Solomon was asked by God, what do I do for you? And what did Solomon say? He just told God, you know what? I do not even know how to thank you because of the great things you've done to my father David. You raised him to become the great king. And you were with him. And you even promised to be with him and even his children. Now what else can I ask of you? The only thing I want you to do is to bless, give me wisdom so that I know how to administer the wealth that you've already given me. May the Lord give you that wisdom this morning. The wisdom to minister the wealth that God is about to release in your your life. Because this is a worthy chance. Praise the Lord. You have to get the wisdom on how you're going to handle the things that God is about to release in your life, the blessings that He's about to release in your life, and even the anointing that God is about to release unto each one of you. This is not going to be an ordinary church anymore. This is going to be a church full of the anointing, full of the Holy Ghost fire. Praise the Lord. Because you have your you don't value what you have more. And in the material things, you don't value as to what you are doing in the spiritual realm. You have touched a bottom that many have never touched. You have touched a place or reached a place that many have never even known. Can you imagine? You have gone to places where others have never gone. Because touching God in that manner, your life will never be the same. Then what happened? Solomon became, after being given the wisdom, he still became the wealthiest man. Because God, when God was asking Solomon, what was he expecting from Solomon? He was expecting from Solomon, make me the most powerful king on the earth. Make me the most, let me have more numbers. Make my military the most powerful one. But what did God, what did he do? He asked for the wisdom. And today, I declare that wisdom will be what you'll be identified with, because people in your place of work will be coming to seek wisdom from you. People even from other churches will be coming to seek wisdom from you, because you have loved and your purpose to honor God with everything you have. Praise you to Jesus. Hallelujah. May we bow for prayer. Just to thank God for these wonderful people. Heavenly Father, I want to thank you this morning for this church that loves King of Glory. They have done something I've never experienced before. Jehovah God, when people do things that you have not even expected them to do. Lord, when people touch a button in your life where you did not even imagine that people can touch. King of Glory, this was not what we have done unto you this morning. They have entered a realm that others have never known. King of Glory, they have entered and penetrated into a place that people have never known. Lord, I want to declare this morning that the blessings of the Lord will overtake them. That the wisdom of God will be in abundance in their life. King of Glory, I declare that you are releasing the wealth of the nation and the treasures that are hidden in the secret places. Father, you are revealing to this party. My God, their health should die, the God of more than enough. Jehovah, when they came and when you gave them that prophetic word, El Shaddai, King of Glory, properly they did not know what they are entering into. Jehovah, remember that name is used only in Joseph's life. El Shaddai saying that God, my God, is more than enough. He's a God of abundance. I am declaring abundance in this church. Abundance in everything, in the anointing, the habit in abundance. My Father, the wealth of the nations will be in abundance in this place. My Father, there will be an abundance of souls in this house. I declare there will be an abundance that has never been experienced in the county of Mombasa. My Father, I declare that the rich and the wealthy in this county, you are directing them into this church. In the mighty name of Jesus, I want to declare that this body will never experience lack in their lives in the name of Jesus. Unto you. My anything, but they will be full of abundance, will be full of your peace, full of your joy. My God, and they will be the ones supplying even to other ministries, because you are making them wealthy and greater. I thank you for your power and your love that is upon each one of them. Thank you.